of the letter is the secret meeting that changed rap music and destroyed a generation.
I had like 2 record deals, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
they wanted your butt?
Yeah.
I remember seeing Puff come through, and Puff had like 5 bodyguards with him. And this was like one of the only times Puff ever stopped to speak to me.
Did you think that n****s would really be wearing dresses, beads in their hair and all that shit?
And if anything happens to me after I bring up this subject, you know what it is.
Soon as I walked out the club, Tracy Waples, she outside in a Benz like, Meph, come on, get in the car. I'm like, I'm not making a connection here. And I'm like, oh, that's Puff car. That's Puffy car. Ain't no way I'm getting in them.
On most days, the music industry is an embodiment of art. And while it can be amazing in the daytime, when the night comes, it is an entirely different story. These aren't the words of some random spectator. Oh no, these actually came from active participants of the industry. According to reports, not only do upcoming artists get subjected to different levels of debauchery, but some of them are even forced as far as filming very explicit content against their will. And while talks of these inhumane actions have already been making rounds on social media, even more disturbing news have come up on it. And guess which record executive happens to be at the center of it all? That's right, none other than Sean Diddy Combs.
I had like 2 record deals, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
they wanted your butt?
Yeah.
Hold on.
I mean, looking at the industry from the outside, you'd think all of these rappers blowing up were only signed because of their talent in making music. However, it seems that talent might be more available than we think. But the things these artists have to do to get signed, that's a whole new story. Things in the industry are reportedly so bad that there are certain rituals. Don't get me wrong, every industry has its own rituals. But in this case, the rituals are reportedly bordering on and while that's perfectly fine, it becomes a different story when the artists being imposed are actually straight.
He with it. That's you telling him, like, yeah, I'm ready. And then next thing you know, you get invited to the party with the greeting is the man squeezing your Whoa!
Looks like the entertainment industry might not be what we thought after all. And although it's easy to think of this as far-fetched, it's actually more common than you'd expect. At least that's how Puff's name came into the mix. Diddy likes to portray himself in public as a dedicated father and family man, but his private activities show an entirely different picture of the music producer. Many incidents have been revealed where Diddy would purposely go after young straight male rappers. He would force them into performing acts on him. While he was undoubtedly one of the bigger names in the rap scene of the 1990s, recent revelations suggest that he may not be the straightforward individual that most people perceive him to be. These are not just baseless rumors. Even the late rapper DMX publicly exposed Diddy for his questionable behavior and mistreatment of the late Biggie Smalls. DMX tragically passed away in April of 2021, shortly after suffering a heart attack at White Plains Hospital in New York. However, before his untimely death, he left the world stunned with some shocking revelations about Diddy. According to DMX, Biggie Smalls revealed to him a secret about Puff Daddy's on him back when he was still known as Diddy or Love. It's a shocking revelation that exposes a dark side of the music industry that most people never get to see. And the hits keep coming. DMX also shared a tale from his days as an unsigned artist, where he almost landed a record deal with Bad Boy, but was passed over in favor of The Lox. You know The Lox got signed before I did. They were a safer group, said DMX. Puff signed them, and you know it was a blessing and a curse because they were happy they got signed, and they were on The Benjamins. But then he, Diddy, made them jiggy and put them in suits and made them write lyrics for him and took their publishing and them.
Fucking didn't sign first, and they were on The Benjamins, and shit was going. But then he made him jiggy and put him in suits and made them write lyrics for him and took all that publishing and f***ed him.
In a recent interview, DMX made a revelation that Diddy rejected signing him because he didn't consider the Rough Riders anthem rapper to be marketable. However, some individuals are now speculating that there may be more to this story. Could it be possible that Diddy turned down DMX because he didn't find him attractive enough to fulfill his own desires? After all, long-standing rumors have circulated for years suggesting that Diddy has a preference for men. Considering that other artists who may have passed through these same things have come out to speak about their experiences, it checks out that that's a pretty good chance DMX knew exactly what he was talking about at the time. And if you're not sold on that X's revelation, there's a lot more from where it came. Only that this time, the big reveals are coming from Jaguar Wright. In a lengthy video, the talented singer made shocking allegations against the music executive, promising to reveal the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Wright claimed that she had hired an entertainment lawyer who had worked with Bad Boy around 2003. This lawyer shared an unsettling story with her about her time at the label.
She's a lawyer, or at least she was. She used to be an entertainment lawyer. I'm not gonna say her name. The story is enough.
Apparently, Diddy had a meeting with singer and actor Christopher Williams about a demo deal. The attorney went to Diddy's office to get approval for some paperwork. And when she walked in, she saw Williams performing fellatio on Puff.
When she walked in, the door wasn't locked, so she didn't think twice about just walking in. And when she walked in, she saw Christopher Williams performing fellatio on Puff.
Such a surprising sight didn't seem to bother the lawyer until Diddy brought it up the next day. He allegedly asked her if she intended on telling anyone and threatened to ruin her life if she did. Jaguar then went off at Diddy, accusing him of using his power in order to get Christopher Williams to perform fellatio for him to get a demo deal.
See, Christopher Williams, I don't know, I guess he wanted to sign. I don't know what happened, but Puff was supposed to be giving him a demo deal, and he gave him a demo deal.
Jaguar, truly like a Jaguar, has her jaws wrapped around Diddy's head here, as she also goes on to claim that he tried to chase the lawyer and even Wendy Williams out of New York. Wright was adamant that Diddy had used his power to force men into degrading acts to prove how powerful he was. She's not afraid to speak her mind and talk about how he better not try to come after the lawyer that walked in on Diddy because she was under Jaguar's protection. Jaguar continued to pop off at Diddy, saying he needs to pay reparations to everyone who ever signed for Bad Boy Records because there's a good chance Diddy abused them all. Honestly, these accusations are absolutely bonkers, but if they're true, they're going to spell the end for Diddy. Christopher Williams went on to respond to this absolute tirade from Jaguar in a very curious manner indeed, almost making it seem like Jaguar was lying about everything. See for yourself. It's almost like Christopher is trying to brush Jaguar's words off as nothing but foolish rambling. But it could just easily be that Chris is scared of Diddy's power and influence and doesn't want to speak out against him by agreeing with Jaguar. That is a very common and unfortunate power dynamic that exists in relationships like these. Well, Diddy is a strange man indeed, and expectedly, strange things turn him on. But the going gets even weirder, as one of Diddy's favorite things to do is luring straight men into his cars and making them have sex with him. Diddy didn't just do this to some random artist. He did it to rapper Method Man in LA.
I remember seeing Puff come through, and Puff had like 5 bodyguards with him. And this is like one of the only times Puff ever stopped to speak to me.
Method Man was sitting in a club in LA when Diddy approached him. Diddy must have been attracted to him because he then proceeded to hit on him in a rather weird way.
As I walked out the club, B, Tracy Waples, she outside in a Benz like, Meth, come on, get in the car. I'm not making a connection here. And I'm like, oh, that's Puff car. That's Puffy car. Ain't no way I'm getting in that motherfucker.
Instead of talking some more than inviting Method Man to his place like a normal person, he decided to send someone else to trick him into sitting in the car. It's almost as if this is a game for Diddy, and he enjoys putting these straight men in uncomfortable positions. Method Man wasn't the only straight man Diddy had sneakily tricked into an uncomfortable position. Another rapper, Exhibit, has come forward with his horror story. Diddy invited him home for a good time and then took him clubbing, only to find out later that this club wasn't just an average club. Instead, it was a very explicit gay club. Exhibit was ignorantly trying to party and have a good time when someone pointed out to him that the men at the club were kissing. Exhibit was taken aback, but didn't think anything of it until he saw another man dancing butt naked in the middle of the club. That's when he realized that Diddy had tricked him and taken him along to a gay club. Diddy has never openly admitted to his attraction to men, but he's also unafraid of being caught acting his fantasies out. In fact, in private parties and events, he very openly acts gay. And that just might be because he wants prospective artists to have an idea of what they might be getting into, but doesn't make it any less unusual. Even fans all over the world have heard the tale of Diddy's antics, and some of them even seem to believe it's a lot worse than what we're already seeing. One user wrote, "Some say, oh, it's fashion when the same rappers you defend confess about it. They rape your favorite rappers, and they rape each other too. Satanist Diddy might be the upcoming head of gays. They get tattooed to feel touch because they lose their manhood already. Open your eyes. I mean, if it really is as bad as this, then it's only a matter of time before they get exposed. That's it for this video. Goodbye.